And antibiotics have long been linked to asthma, but exactly how the medication predisposes patients to the condition has remained a mystery until now. Monash University scientists have found antibiotic exposure in babies depletes a specific bacteria in the gut that also protects infants' airways. It ultimately leaves key lung cells unprotected, increasing the risk of developing asthma. For more on this is research lead Professor Benjamin Marsland, the head of Monash University's Department of Immunology. Really appreciate you talking with us today. Thank you so much. Tell us a bit more about your findings. What do we actually now know between that link between antibiotic exposure and asthma in children?
Well, thanks for having me. It's a pleasure. The new discovery revolves around the depletion of certain microbes, which are perhaps considered to be healthy bacteria in our guts, which can occur when with antibiotic treatment. And as a consequence of depleting those healthy bacteria, we lose a molecule called IPA, or indole 3 propionic acid. This molecule is produced in the gut, and it goes all the way to the lungs, where it protects airway cells as they're developing. So early in life, the absence of this molecule can lead to an increased risk of asthma later in life.
So, Professor, now that we've identified the problem, should we now be able to find a solution, a fix, or some way of preventing that impact for those small children who do actually need to take antibiotics in the first year of life, for example?
Absolutely, because I should really say clearly that antibiotics are a critical piece of the arsenal. We need to have antibiotics, and people should be using them in order to treat infections. But the goal for us going forward would be to perform a clinical trial where infants are given antibiotics, which are supplemented with this small molecule, IPA. It's a natural product. We know it's safe. And ideally, that would offset the detrimental effects of antibiotics and benefit and protect the infant from developing asthma later in life.
And so, Benjamin, do we know, is it prolonged use of antibiotics or even just one course in that first year of life, for example, that could actually make all the difference?
Yeah, the data suggests that it's recurrent episodes of antibiotic use, and particularly in the first year of life. So likely two or three exposures to antibiotics in that first year of life is linked with risk of asthma later. And a molecule like IPA might be given at the same time as those antibiotics, just in early life, just during the antibiotics. And perhaps our data indicates that that could be sufficient to protect against the detrimental side effects of antibiotics.
Professor Benjamin Marsland, really appreciate you bringing us up to date with your findings. I appreciate that. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you.